Hey, this is Mike. I'm in Whiteville, North Carolina, visiting Van Underwood Chrysler Jeep Dodge Ram, and I'm checking out a 2016 Jeep Wrangler Sahara Unlimited. This is a really, really sweet Jeep. And have you ever just pulled into a parking lot and just a vehicle just really grabbed your attention? Well, that's what happened today. I pulled into the parking lot, saw this Jeep, and I just had to check it out. It's just really awesome, especially when I love black vehicles when they're nice and clean and shiny like this, with the 18-inch aluminum wheels and the accents there on the front just really grabbing my attention. I was just couldn't look away, even though there's a Hellcat in the background. That just didn't really, this was more eye-grabbing to me. So let's go ahead and check it out. 18-inch aluminum wheels with the gray background kind of accenting the aluminum there, and it has the ventilated disc brakes here in the front. Really awesome Bridgestone tires with the Sahara. You have non-ventilated, basically just solid disc brakes here in the back. Take a look on this side. Now, a lot of people are trading these in, just like their SUVs and stuff like that in on the Wranglers with the four-door model, especially the Sahara, because it has a very high-end appeal for a lot of people. So check out the Sahara symbol they got going on here with the dunes and everything. That looks awesome. Then you got the trail rated badge, letting you know that it can handle some off-road activity, of course. So here in the front, we have the round halogen reflector headlights, pretty traditional with the Wranglers, and the 7-slot grille with the silver accents there, kind of matching the wheels. And then you have the accents around the headlights, which is really neat. Shiny black bumper there on the front. And a lot of people think that the Sahara's fenders are actually metal, but they are plastic, just like the Sport. They're just painted, so that's why they're shiny. But they are plastic for a reason. It makes it a lot more resilient to bumps and things like that if you're doing some off-roading, and also corrosion and all that stuff. So check out these tow hooks here in the front. Kind of blending in there. Plus you have the halogen fog lights here at the bottom, kind of more in a center position. You have some skid panels there. So here's the key, and you see it has a couple buttons on here. It has the lock and unlock button and the panic button there, but it also, this particular one, has the remote start. And let's take a look here at the back. So let's go ahead and remote start it. You just have to make sure the vehicle is locked, and then you just double tap this button here. It's going to beep twice, and it'll start right up. If you want to then turn it off, it'll actually run for 15 minutes and before it turns off. And once it turns off, you can remote start it again, but then you can't do that more than 3 times. So to turn it off, we can just double tap that button again, turns it right back off. So let's go ahead and take a look on the inside. Just push the unlock button, make sure it's unlocked. Let's check it out. Here's the inside of the passenger door. Pretty simple, basic design. It is a Wrangler, so it's made for durability and also to be able to remove the doors. They one of the things they don't have in here is the power window switch. The power window switch is located somewhere else, which I'll show you. But you can actually remove the doors. Quite simple, and it actually comes with the tool to do so. So down here you have a little net pocket which keeps things secure, so you can put something in there, and if you're going over bumpy terrain, it's not going to rattle around in, like, say, an open pocket. It's going to be more secure on the door. So you have these steps here on the side, which helps out with the looks and also getting in the vehicle. So, and this one does have the grab handles, which will be mounted here. I'll show you those in a second. They'll be mounted right here. They are a like a strap type grab handle, so you can help you get in the vehicle. Plus you have this handle right here for off-roading. So check out these seats, black leather Sahara seats with the contrast stitching in white. And then you have the Sahara name embroidered in the back of the seats. And there's your headrest. Pretty decent amount of leg room. And let me make sure, manual adjustments on all the seats here. But there's the maximum amount of leg room here in the front. And we'll see how that stacks up to the room we have here in the back. Okay, so with the seat all the way back, there's your leg room. Okay, so here I am sitting in the back seat and really pretty comfortable. The seat, the back part is kind of in a vertical position, and so you're not really leaning back much, but look at the leg room. Putting my knees straight forward, which is not really natural for me. I'm 6 feet tall and my knees are about a half inch away from the front seat. Now if I just relax right here, they're not even close. And plenty of room to put my feet here underneath the seat in different places, and just overall pretty comfortable. We got some speakers here, so I'll be able to hear the music good. And there's a dome light, and this is actually part of your, this plastic over your roll cage. So this is actually a roll cage here all the way back, so that way you're very much protected in case of a rollover. These things are actually to remove your top, your panels. It's a three-piece hard top, so you can remove the front two like T-tops in a way. And then that's what these are for. They unscrew. That's part of removing the front part. There's the inside of the door. Then you have the net pocket. You have some cup holders there. Your power window controls are right there. You have a little light that shines down on the cup holders at night. It's like a little ambient light, which is pretty cool. And this seat folds down. It's a 60-40 split. I'm just gonna fold this down. Now that I put the seat all the way back, it's gonna interfere slightly, but I just want to give you an idea of what it looks like and how it does. You see how the headrest kind of folds back, unhinges and folds back. But real easy to put the seats down and up, and it gives you the ability to have a combination of cargo and passenger space. So you notice that with the hardtop, you have that privacy glass, which is really, really good and very comparable to like a regular SUV. You can get the privacy glass in the soft top, but the hardtop just looks more impressive to me. Okay, so let's take a look here in the back. We have the classic spare tire mounted on the back of the vehicle, and with the Sahara you get a really sweet spare tire. It has the exact same wheel and tire as the rest of the vehicle, and some people actually rotate this tire in with their tires while they're rotating their tires, so that way they can actually get some use out of it besides just sitting there. And you have a trailer tow package on the back of this vehicle, and it has a little plug for plugging in the wiring. And this vehicle can tow up to 3,500 pounds with the four-door version, which is pretty awesome. Then you got the tow hook there, and your single exhaust popping out over here. Okay, so let's take a look here in the back. And of course this locks and unlocks with the key, so we know it's unlocked. This opens up big tailgate there, so this is takes a lot of room to open it up, and you don't want to swing it open and close because it does have an additional weight of the tire and everything here. So you want to make sure that you're, you know, a little bit more careful with it, so that way it you know, I mean, of course it's very durable, but over time if you're swinging things around, it'll wear out faster. That's my two cents anyway. So back here, this lifts up. So now you have this huge amount of space. See, if this was a soft top, that part would not easily be moved out of the way. So it's real easy to have a huge space here in the back. And you can see I have some stuff laid out to show you. But let's just look at the back overall. It has a pretty decent amount of space back here for cargo. And that will expand tremendously when you start folding those seats down. So you can fold down, you have a 60-40 split, the line is right here, so you can put down that seat or that seat and have a combination, like I said, of driver and passenger. Okay, so it has some tie downs that I want to show you. This is important to me. You have these tie downs here for tying down cargo. Okay, there. You also have some up here, but do not get those confused with the latch system for your car seat anchor, which is here. See the difference? This is for your cargo, this is for your car seat. And it has a little reminder here, but still, it's easy to get confused. Okay, so there's some goodies that comes with this vehicle, and this is one of them. It's the toolkit, which allows you to take the doors off, fold down the windshield, take the actual top off. You'll see it has these bolts here, and they're all Torx. So it gives you all the tools you need to do all that stuff that comes with the vehicle. And this one also has some like coat hanger type things that hang up on the inside of the roll bar, roll cage. That way you can hang your clothes on them. You also have those grab handles I was telling you about that mount on the roll cage. And you can see in the little illustration here that, you know, they kind of hang down and you can hold on to them while you're off-roading or getting in and out of the vehicle. Now this right here is just a big bag, and this is for putting your two-piece top, the front two pieces. If you take those off, you can put them in this bag. It has a separator, and once you put them in the bag, it's soft on the inside. You can strap it to the back of this seat, and that way it'll be out of the way and you can still utilize your cargo space while at the same time having a place to store your top panels, which is pretty cool. Okay, so this also has a mat here that's double-sided. You have a rubber side on this side and then a carpet on this side. Of course, Jeep has tons of other accessories that you can use back here. So let's go ahead and open up this little secret compartment here. And so this is securable with the tailgate. Once you close the tailgate, this secures this little area. So even when you have the top off, you'll have this secured. So you can put some stuff in here. You have little pockets. And check out these little screw holes. These are for your door hinges, your roof. And so basically, the whole idea is that if you take a door off, or if you take the, you know, stuff off, you have places to put the screws that are going to that you're going to need to find a place to store them. You definitely don't want to lose those screws. It'll be make it a lot more convenient if you don't lose them, that's for sure. And then your tools for your spare tire are going to be under here. Okay, so closing this back part, we just have to remember to close this top part first, like so. And now we can close this. And like I said, you don't want to kind of slam it. You want to kind of swing it over here, and you can kind of get it right there, and then you can kind of slam it a little bit, but you don't want to just swing the whole thing. Okay, so on the driver's side, which is awesome, is your fuel cap, and it has this little tether system right here so you don't lose your cap, and it doesn't really have a place to hang it. So it's going to kind of dangle down, and it might be a good idea actually to get that clear protective surface and actually put some right here on the fender. On the Sahara, it's not going to make too much of a difference on the Sport or whatever, but on the Sahara you have this shiny painted plastic right here, so it might actually scratch it over time. So that's one thing I would recommend. Okay, so let's take a look on this side. Just give you another point of view. And speaking of slamming doors, these side doors, all these four doors here on the side, you do have to slam. They have this really thick seal here. And so if you just like regular shut it, They don't really, you kind of have to squash that seal. You can actually feel the seal starting to compress right around there. And so it was a lot of, it takes a pretty good amount of force to, you know, shut the doors completely. Because one thing, if you don't shut the door all the way, the remote start won't work. So that's one thing to consider. So starting the vehicle without the remote start is pretty traditional. You just put the key in and turn it. So let's take a look under the hood. And this one, all you have to do is use these right here, here on the side. There's one, and then there's two. And that unlatches it. So like say on a regular vehicle, there's a latch under the hood. Well, those are the latches for that. So there's also under here a kind of safety catch, just like most vehicles. And it's right here in this very center, right above the Jeep. You push it to the right. Here it is there. Kind of move it to the right there. So here's your V6, 3.6 liter, 285 horsepower V6. This is the Pentastar V6. 260 pound-feet of torque. Pretty smooth running engine. This is the engine that they use in a lot of vehicles, Chrysler vehicles. It's in the six-cylinder Charger and Challenger and stuff like that. Lots of different vehicles. But anyways, this is a really, really good engine with a VVT system. So it gives you really good gas mileage and performance and everything. Covered up with plastic, of course. But hopefully you can see a little bit around the outside. There's your battery. So actually, Jeep actually makes this lock that goes under here. And that way you can lock the hood. So if you're in an area and you don't want, you kind of question whether you know, somebody might pop your hood and steal your battery or something like that. They do actually make a lock for this, and it may have a little key under here, and you'll be able to lock your hood. All right, here we are on the inside, 2016 Jeep Wrangler Sahara Unlimited. Checking it out. Now, just want to mention, I put my shade up, but the actual shade, since the windshield was kind of small, I had to kind of fold it over. So if you use a shade regularly, you might want to get like a custom one or maybe trim it down or whatever. So let's go ahead and start here on the steering wheel. And the steering column is a tilt steering column. Goes up and down pretty good ways. And then you lock it in place with this little lever here. Has a leather wrapped, stitched, black steering wheel with the really tough plastic, super durable plastic there, and really good thickness. That's one good thing. I really like a thick steering wheel because it doesn't dig into my hands while I'm driving. It kind of, you know, just more comfortable to me. And so on here on the right side is your cruise control. You can turn it on and off there. You can set it, change through your speed, and then cancel it there. It has a little indicator letting you know that the cruise control is on right there. Okay, so on the back of the steering wheel, right back here, see if I can show you. Right back here, you have a toggle switch and then a center button. And the idea is that once your hand is in place when you're driving, you can use your back fingers to really easy to adjust your volume. So there's your volume for your radio. You can go up and down, and then you have a center button which will cycle through AM, FM, hard drive, stuff like that, CD player. So that's the three buttons on the back of the steering wheel on that side. So on this side, there's same buttons on the back, except for it changes through your stations, the up and down, and then the center button will cycle through your presets, which is pretty cool. So here on the left side, you have your voice recognition button and your Bluetooth phone button. So pushing the voice recognition button will allow you to say commands. So let's go ahead and push that button so you can hear what it sounds like. Help.
Available options are track, number, next track, previous track, category, main menu, or cancel to exit.
Cancel. So it just gives you an idea of what the voice sounds like in the vehicle. And so basically, that's just one option. I mean, you can go to specific addresses in there. Right now it's in the radio hard drive screen, so it's going to give you some options in there. But really cool feature, because you can make calls, receive calls. You can, like, say when you make a call, you can say a specific person, say Stephen Underwood. If he's in your phone book on your phone, you just push the button and say, call Stephen Underwood. I mean, it's really awesome convenience feature, but a tremendous safety feature, because your hands are on your wheel, eyes are on the road, and you are staying productive, which is awesome. So you have these buttons down here, and they correspond with this screen up here. But first, let me show you the gauges. You have your fuel gauge here, speedometer, RPM gauge, and then your engine temperature right there to the right. So right here, you see digital compass, digital temperatures. 92 degrees outside, very humid and hot. So, and at any time you want to go to that part, you can always push this button. But I'm going to just push the menu button here and kind of cycle through some stuff. Digital speedometer, I'm going to go into that so you can see. This is what I would probably have up most of the time, digital speedometer. And let's go here, we'll push menu again, average miles per gallon, miles to empty, tire pressure. Then you have a timer there, more vehicle info, which is pretty cool. You can go into coolant temperature, oil life, oil pressure, transmission temperature, and that's your vehicle info there. Pushing menus again, you can go and change your units to like the metric system or something. And then keep going, personal settings, and it scrolls back to there. But anytime you want to see the digital compass, you just push this button there. So there's your buttons for your menu system. Pretty cool. You don't actually have to go in there and check your tire pressure or anything. It'll actually tell you if anything's kind of out of spec. But it has it there if you want it. So your headlight controls are right here. You just have the off, parking lights, headlights, and then you have an automatic feature. And the fog lights are turned on by pulling this out like so, and you have a little indicator there letting you know that they're on. I really like the automatic feature, it's awesome. And then your dimmer is right here. So on this side is your windshield wiper controls for the front and back. Take a look at the dash here, and there's a storage cubby up here for putting some stuff. So here's your radio. It's a touchscreen radio with a hard drive, 40 gig hard drive, and you can put music on the hard drive, music and pictures actually, using this DVD drive, or it plays CDs. You also have the ability to put stuff on the hard drive using this USB port, so you can use like a little flash drive or something. And then you have this auxiliary input for playing music. You also have the voice recognition and phone button here, your radio button there. Let me turn that down. Radio buttons here. Media, that's where you play music through other sources besides the radio. So you have AM, FM, satellite radio. Your presets are there to the right, and you can direct tune to different things there. And you have your clock there as well. Pushing media will give you the options of different media options that you have at the time. So like say auxiliary is not illuminated right now because we don't have anything plugged in. But this is really cool. You got the navigation, so you can push the navigation screen. We can view the map. We can kind of see where we're at, get our bearings. And then we can always go back and we can put in specific addresses. We can save our home address. We can have favorites. All that good stuff in our navigation screen. And settings, like say you can tell it to take you to the closest or the fastest route, or avoid traffic or avoid highways or whatever. This is your signal strength of your GPS system. And got a menu system right here. This is where you can set up your navigation. And TravelLink, which is pretty cool. This is where you can get some really awesome information. Of course, your forecast, like weather forecast, tells you it's gonna rain and stuff like that recently, you know, pretty soon. But you can also get, say if you're in an area where you're not familiar, you can get your fuel prices. And the fuel prices, not only can you get the prices, but also you can get the distance, so you can find your nearest gas station. So if you're out in a place where you're not familiar with, you can shop for gas. I mean, you can find the nearest gas station, but you can also find comparable prices. Right now it's not up to date, it's not loaded in there yet, but sometimes that happens. But usually it'll show all the prices there. And then you can change your fuel type. So, you know, if you want to find 93 octane, some gas stations don't have that. This vehicle doesn't really need it, but if you wanted to use that, you can, of course, search for that as well. So lots of other cool stuff in there too, with the TravelLink, really awesome feature. So just kind of give you an idea. Also, My Files, this is where you can manage your hard drive. You have the ability to put music and pictures in there. You can actually have like a little background. So like say on your radio screen, you can have like a little background picture with your family or whatever there if you wanted to. Really cool. So that's your main, kind of the main overview of the radio system. Lots and lots of different features, but you know, that's just the main stuff there. Of course, you have a volume knob if you want to, and you can always turn it off, and you can have just the clock there if you wanted to. Okay, so down here is your power windows, and the front two are automatic, so you just push it and it quickly goes down. Lifting it up though, you kind of have to hold it. So that's your power windows for all four windows. And you can lock out the windows if you want in the back. So if you've got kids in the back, you don't want them playing around with the windows, you can lock those out right there if you need to. Okay, so your climate control is an automatic feature. Your fan speed, there's recirculate the air. There's your temperature, and then your air conditioning. You can turn that feature on and off. But so the temperature is the actual, have numbers there. So you can set it to a specific temperature and put everything on auto, and it'll kind of do its thing and, you know, try to give you the like a thermostat, I guess you could say, in your house. But you can manually change where you want the air to blow and all that stuff too. So your side mirrors that are heated, by the way, are controlled here, and you just have to pick a side, left or right, and then you adjust it like a little joystick just right where you want it. On this side is a 12 volt power supply, and you notice it has a little key there that's letting us know that it is turned on and off with the ignition. So here in the front we have heated seats, a two-stage, so you have high and low for both the driver and the passenger. So there's the driver, there's the passenger. You have a traction control button here, which you can turn off. It's always on unless you turn it off. This is a downhill descent button. This is only for off-road use. So if you're going downhill, it will kind of keep you at a steady, slow pace without letting you slide around too far, slide too much, or rapidly go down the hill. It's only for kind of loose gravel or slippery surfaces. Four-way flashers are here. Now this is to turn on and off your Edison plug, which is right here. And it's a, just like you'd find in your house, Edison plug, and you can plug stuff in there. It's not going to power a hair dryer or anything, but it will be able to power, so like you can charge your laptop and stuff like that. And you do have to turn it on with that button or it will not work. Okay, so you have this little net pocket here for putting stuff. I guess you could put your maybe sunglasses or something there as well. A place to put some pins or something there. So here's your shifter, and this is your four-wheel drive shifter. You have two-wheel drive high, four-wheel drive high, neutral, and four-wheel drive low. So here's your normal transmission for your automatic five-speed transmission. You can put it in reverse like that. Neutral, and then drive. And now that you're in drive, if you need to change the gears manually, you could just bump it to the right or left. And you'll know which gear you're in because it'll show you up here. And if you accidentally bump it, like you're driving along, you accidentally bump it and you go into a different gear, then you can just push and hold it to the right and it'll go back in drive. So that's that. Cup holder is right here. And then you have a emergency brake. You can see this little Jeep Easter egg here on the bottom. There's lots of little Easter eggs in this vehicle. And I pointed them out before in the 15 model. They're pretty much the same in this one. I'll show you a couple of them. So here is
your armrest, and it's pretty good size. You can share it with your passenger there. It is a lockable armrest. And same thing with your glove compartment. So that's one thing with the Wrangler. You have some places like the glove compartment's lockable. The center armrest is lockable, and then you that little secret compartment I showed you in the back's lockable. So that way, if you have the doors off or the top off, you have some level of securing your stuff. So this has two openings. You see, it has two buttons here. You have a little one and a big one. The little one opens up the little pocket right here for putting small stuff in there. You have a little place for wires to go in and out. So if you have an iPod or a cell phone in there, you can have a wire going out of this compartment down into the other one or completely out. So let's go ahead and open up the second compartment. And there's another place where wires can go in and out there on the sides. And you have a USB port for charging. You also have a power supply down there. And this particular power supply has the, see if you can see that, has the battery on it. So that way you can actually plug things in there. Let's say if you want to plug in your cell phone while you're going into the store or something, it'll stay on even if the ignition's off. So you have an auto dim rear view mirror up here, and it's kind of auto dimming right now. I don't know if you can notice that because of the shades kind of blocking the light sensor. But you can turn that feature on and off. I'm gonna go ahead and turn it off so you can see the difference. You can see it lightening up like so. There's your visor, has a mirror there. Same thing on that side. Up here is your kind of T-top, so you can see it, the ways of unlatching it here and here. And then you have a latch there at the back, one here in the middle. And then of course you have to unscrew these things all the way out, and you can take these tops off. Just to take a look at the visibility in the back. All right, there you have it. 2016 Jeep Wrangler Unlimited Sahara. Awesome, awesome Jeep. Really caught my attention, love it. And I think you will too. Take one for a test drive. The longer wheelbase of the Unlimited really helps out on the highway versus just a regular Jeep. So if you've ever driven a two-door Jeep, if you've never driven a four-door Jeep, you wanna go ahead and take a test drive and see how you like it, because it may be something you're interested in. There's your microphone for your Bluetooth system right up here. Okay, so lots and lots of features I can go on forever. But anyways, thank you for watching, and thank you to Van Underwood Chrysler Jeep Dodge Ram here in Whiteville, North Carolina, for allowing me to show off an awesome Jeep. And I'll see you next time.